We have hygrometers in three sizes, 1 7/16 inches, 2 3/4, and 3.5. Plenty of variety for everyone. Hygrometers are probably the most misunderstood of the weather instruments. They give relative humidity, in other words, the amount of water in the air, as a percentage. For example, if it's 20% humidity, you're probably in Arizona or New Mexico, where it's very dry. If it's 98% humidity, well, you might be in Houston. If it's summer in Houston and 50% humidity inside your home, then you have a really good air conditioning system. Instead of a bimetallic coil as seen in a thermometer, hygrometers use a metal coil coated with a chemically impregnated paper. Any changes in the humidity or water vapor cause the coil to bend, resulting in movement of the indicator hand. Never, ever touch the coil with your fingers. It will contaminate it. Like our thermometers, one end of the coil is attached to the case, the other is attached to the shaft that holds the indicator hand. The bending coil causes the indicator hand to move as the humidity changes. It's surprising how important humidity can be. Hygrometers are used in saunas, greenhouses, museums, and factories that apply paint and various coatings. Proper care of wood musical instruments requires the use of a hygrometer as well. In your home, low humidity increases static electricity and dry skin. High humidity can encourage mold growth. It's not a bad idea to have hygrometers around you. In the late 1700s, the first hygrometers were made using human hair, about 10 inches long under tension. These early hygrometers were made even more accurate by using ether to remove some of the oils found in human hair. Whalebone was also used for hygrometers. They have been around for a long time. Our hygrometers actually measure the absence of water. To do this properly, initially, the hygrometer needs to be charged. You can do this by quickly folding a very warm, moist towel, placing the backside of the hygrometer on it. Within a few minutes, the reading on your hygrometer should be about 95%. If it's not, then use the setting screw on the back to adjust the indicator hand to about 95%. Your hygrometer is now set for several years of good operation. A popular use for hygrometers is cigar humidors. In the late 1990s, these were so popular that all worldwide production could not keep up with the demand. It would be virtually impossible to find a good humidor today that did not have a hygrometer in it. For all the men and women who occasionally smoke a cigar, a humidor is a popular item. It's also a popular item for woodworkers to make. When you do decide to smoke a cigar, it's nice that it's not too dry or wet, just right if you're so inclined. We are clockparts.com and I'm Mike Brossman. I hope you've learned about the value of a hygrometer or two around the house. Feel free to call us at 888-827-2387 or visit our website at www.clockparts.com. Thanks for watching.